man after the king of Ameke that wears footwear.
Onyeko. Odogu.
Yeah.
Odogu. Odogu.
Afam, afam. I thought you join other young men who decided to relocate to other distant land out of our own land because they got tired.
Chinua, why would you say a thing like that?
Hey, because I've not seen you in ages.
That's true. You see, you have not seen me in ages because I've been running around for your sake.
My sake?
Wow. You see what? Go inside. Arrange all the money. In fact, because I've done a great job for you.
No, nah, go on.
Oh, what did you get at Jolomi?
What job, really?
Ah, DJ Jimba, of course. Everything is almost complete.
Hey!
Kiko inki na mwamu kunyara.
Oh, I'm happy.
Oh, asokwam.
By the way, what was her response?
She said she would think about it. Yeah. And you know what it means when a woman says that.
Hey, she will certainly say yes.
Mwamu! How did you know?
I know! Okay, Dika.
You have done well. Wanna, let me tell you, I will pay you immensely for this. For a job well done. You know, I was on my way out before you came in. So why don't you accompany me to where I'm going to?
That would be nice, though, but about the money now.
Yes, and I.
Bow. Yeah, Odogu
Keo. When we go and come back, I'll pay you the money. Eh? Would it be a problem?
Let us go. You are the richest young man in our Iruka
age. Obiakwa.
Awu go dey kwela ato ma. E ma le mo ihe nkwa na
dem mo. You know, we just do our best. Okay, yeah, my
man.
Afam, because of this thing you just said, like, we will finish going to where I'm going to come back, in Bogagi, Ogun, Wagen.
Ew!
I still don't know what you're doing here.
Ujungwa, I don't know what to do. My father threw me out of the house because I am pregnant. Ugunna is responsible and I'm here as his wife.
Are you this brainless? Oh, your father imposed you on a jobless man that cannot even fend for himself. And you are here. Relax. See yourself as his wife. Obiageli jikwanyagi.
I'm confused. I don't know what to do. If I go back to my father's house, he's going to kill me.
Forget your father's house. Go to your grandmother's place.
Exactly what I did. I went to my grandmother's place. And she equally threw me out. I am lost. I don't know how I allowed Uganda to use me like this.
See, Obiageli, it's okay. It's okay. Now I see the mess you're into. You see, teenage pregnancy is actually taboo in America.
Hey,
this is serious.
I'm finished.
Okay, I want to say, kid. He's well, okay? He's okay.
Chima, wait, is this not the route leading to Adeji Zidemba's house? Wait, where are we going actually?
Wait, is it that you don't trust me or what?
It's not like I don't trust you, but I need to know where we are going to. Come, are we actually going to see her?
Listen. See, time will tell. Why don't you follow me? I'm leading. Just follow me, oh?
No problem.
Just follow me. Come now,
bargain. I say, honey, bam, obu. Chino, what are we doing here? You know, this is the house of this. I
need it, them.
Welcome.
How are you?
I'm well. your friend?
Oh, yes. Do you know him?
His face looks familiar. I'm not sure. I may have seen him one or two times.
She barely knows you.
What is the problem?
Oh, nothing. My friend here has been boasting that two of you know each other very well.
You don't need all that.
Really? Don't mind.
Let me get you some coffee.
Okay, I'm waiting. I will not have to ask you for all the money you've collected from me. But with the time we get to my house, I want to have everything.
Chinua, I'm your friend.
Sebapo.
Mwakine me yan.
Go.
Amali changwa lechaba, my sweet love. Mwapo no no go, my sweet love. Nekwa nungwa chatora chato, my sweet love. Mwapo no no go, my sweet love. Mwane kwenu sweet love, mwane kwenu, my sweet love. Mwapo tanu taka isi chikesibe, my sweet love.
Why would Chinua do this to me? Eh, my own friend. In front of that deadly girl.
My love, I was expecting to see you wear the footwear I bought for you.
Why?
Listen, because people respect me a lot in Ameke because I'm the only one after the king who puts on footwear. So I want them to accord the same respect to you.
Love, I am so pleased to hear that. But you see, I am saving that footwear for special occasions.
No, Adichie Jemba, don't say that. I want you to wear it every time, all the time. To the stream, to the village square, to the market square, to fetch water. Wear it all the time. You know why? Listen, the gods of Ameke have blessed the works of my hand. And I know the man of Ezeowele who makes this footwear. Ada, if this footwear spoils, I'll buy another one. What?
I'm still very surprised at you.
Why?
This is Chinua. Chinua that could not look at my face before.
No.
Chinua that could almost not speak whenever he saw me. You have changed. Do you know that?
That is a part of my life that I don't want to remember again. Please.
It's okay.
Yes, please.
I'm not complaining. Although I miss that part of you.
You must be joking. Listen to me, Ada. That part of my life disgusts me. It does.
I still wonder why you did all that. Could it have been love?
Well, yes. Love so strong. I was consumed by that love. And I was drunk with your love.
Huh.
Yes.
So what has changed now?
Now?
You have suddenly become the boldest man alive. Or have you stopped loving me?
Oh, no. Listen, I don't know how to answer that question, but all I want to tell you is that my love for you remains undying. Listen, let's stop talking about the past. Let's talk about you and I. Come. Okay?
Of all the men in Sinameke. It is that mad one that you have decided to marry.
Mama, 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 please. I will not have you call her name. Don't try it again. Okay?
Whatever name I call her is what she is. I will not stay alive and watch you end up with that fighter.
Mama, what kind of language is that? I'm talking about the one you did. You're still calling her names. Fighter. Has she fought you before? This is the only girl I've decided to love in my life. You will not have you. You're calling her a fighter.
I am calling her a fighter because she is indeed a fighter. Kill any useless emotion you are building for that wild animal that came in the body of a maiden, because you will never bring her into this family.
Okay, I'll see who's going to stop me. Have I ever brought any woman in this compound before? Have you ever seen me with any woman here? Have you? The only one I brought that.
I'm warning you.
Let me see who is going
Chenua,
to stop me.
I'm warning you.
Okay.
Chenua.
I'm going. Let me see who is going to stop me. You put to come and stop it.
Don't say I didn't warn you.
Let me see who's going to stop me. Come now, let me marry you.
Chenua. Okay.
Yes. Huh? It's hunting time. Let's go.
Wait. What are you doing with the cutlass?
To kill squirrels, antelopes, and a host of...
Wait. Ah, Dejemba. Wait. You think this is what I've been using to kill all the animals I've been sending to you?
Look at you. You must think that because they call you the great hunter, that you're better than me at it. Come. Today, I will show you my hunting skills.
Wait. You know something? I wish this community would get to know this side of you. You know, Ada, you're such a nice person. Loving, caring, hardworking. I can just go on and on and on and on.
You. Are you trying to woo me properly now?
Well, it wouldn't be a bad idea if I do that, would it?
Well, not today. Try again next time. For now, the only thing on my mind is hunting. Let us go.
Where the hunter, the son of Egundu and little Keke. What are they doing together?
Nai, I just told you that I went to see Obiageri, and you're not saying anything.
Have you noticed that Chinualumogu has been visiting Adai Ejejemba lately?
Chinualumogu? Who is Chinualumogu?
Little Kike's son, the hunter.
Oh, Chinua, Egondo's son.
Yes.
I have seen both of them together before. But what has that got to do with what I just told you? I went to see Obiageri at her husband's house, and she's not living well at all.
You know, what baffles me is why will such a responsible man look the way of Adaiji Jemba?
Chineke,
must she always get the best?
Hey! Nai, what has who looks at that Eje Jemba's way got to do with you? How does it concern what we are talking about now? Eh? Nai, must you bother yourself with things that do not concern you? Eh? I am talking about my own daughter, our daughter, Obiageri, that she's about to die of starvation at Ugonna the drunk's house. And you're here bothering yourself about who is looking at Adeje Jemba's way.
We are saying the same thing. Huh? My wife, we are talking about the same thing.
Hey!
But what I'm asking is, why will Adeje Jemba attract attention of all the good men in this community?
No, look, no more.
Why?
Hey!
Why is our daughter stoned? Why?
Hey.
Oh, we've had your point, Aji, we're pointing. Huh? Was she created different?
Hey. Chineke. Ilo putife. Okay de. Lekwe no manya o. Hey.
Huh?
Chineke me.
Eh? Tell me something, my friend. No wonder he looks more confident these days. He has gotten what he always wanted.
But I told you he likes me a lot. Didn't I?
Mana, what is your name? Did you approach him or he actually approached you?
Hey, what kind of question is that? Does it matter? The most important thing is that we are together and we are happy.
Hey, you're happy. I'm happy for you, my friend.
Thank you.
I'm so happy.
Darling,
you're looking beautiful.
Thank you. Guess what I discovered?
What?
He is the one that has been secretly within my farm.
Hewo! Really? He truly loves you.
I know.
And to think that he was dying in silence. Chai! Honestly, I feel for him. Chai!
I shall take my leave now. He's waiting for me somewhere. Oh, look at my feet. Look at.
Hey.
Look at. Courtesy of my chinois. I am now one of the privileged few in Amweke land to own a footwear.
This is beautiful. Huh.
I know.
You're very lucky, Ada.
Dalu?
Hey! Adeje Jemba. The warrior maiden of Ameke is in love with a man that couldn't look into her face before.
All that is history now. Now, he looks into my face. And believe me, it's a wonderful experience.
Hey.
When he looks into my eyes, it is. I have to go.
Hey!
Mama, please, for God's sake, allow me to go out. Ogene, Ashi, you are not going anywhere.
Oh,
you think I don't know what you have been doing? The news is all over the village that you have been sneaking around with that mad maiden. And I know you are going to meet her.
Mama, for God's sake, what has she done to you? Why are you calling her all these names?
Are you asking me? She is a fighter. She is mannerless. She is disrespectful. Even our uncle came to warn me to beware of her. Our own uncle spoke about her like that. And you think I will allow you to bring that kind of maid into this house? No way!
Okay, can I ask you a question, Mama? Has Adeje Jemba ever fought you before? No. Has she ever disrespected you? No.
So why are you judging her based on what people have said? Why?
The voice of the people is the voice of the gods. Besides, I have seen her beating up a man. A man like you.
Did you bother to find out what the man did? Did you?
Mama, Adeje Jemba is a good girl. She fights against those who step on her feet. She fights for justice.
try and know her first before you judge her, Mama. Because
the gods forbid, I will never get to know her. The earlier you understand this, the better for you. There is no future between you and that maiden. Absolutely no future. Do you understand?
Mama.
Mama, what's all this now? Mama, let me in. Okay.
Although I didn't like the way she confronted me, but I don't blame the poor woman.
Have I not warned you severally about your fighting habits? Have I not?
Mama, you know I am not as bad as people paint me to be. I just hate it when people are mean. I can't stand it.
I know you can't change your past, but at least you can turn a new leaf. Chinua might not marry you, but you have other men coming for you.
Mama, if you're taking that direction of topic now because of Nduka, then I'll have you know that I do not care for it, not tonight.
Nduka is a good man. You know that, don't you? He can't wait forever.
As if I asked him to wait. As for me, it's either Chinua or nobody else. Besides, why do you sound as if Nduka has been talking to you behind my back?
I don't blame the poor boy. He loves you. Is it that Chinua or nobody? Okay. Let me see how you're going to jump into his house when his mother does not even want you.
My one and only Adeje Jemba. The woman that means the world to me. It is nice to behold your beautiful face again.
What are you doing? Wokemechipuanoge! What have you been telling my mother?
I told her nothing but the truth.
Which is?
Listen, Ada. I am a young man that has the advantage of emerging as the next king of Ameke Kingdom. Ada, I love you. I want to make you my wife. Ada, please say yes, and I will marry you tomorrow. Ada, is this what I get for loving you?
Your love does not mean anything to me. Your royalty also does not mean a thing to me. Do not go talking to my mother again. Stop going to her to talk nonsense. I forbid you, Nduka. The next time you try it, I will kill you. Adeje Jemba!
I will kill you. But you know I love... Ada! Ada! Please, Ada! Ada!
Oh, but you know it. You know I am not as bad as they paint me to be. I just don't know why people will not understand me.
Ada, it does not matter if they don't understand you.
I understand you. That's the most important thing. Okay?
Listen to me. As my mother, I will talk to her. I know. Once I continue talking to her, she will definitely listen to me. Okay? I understand you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Joe. You better get going.
I will see you later.
Yes.
Farewell. Go.
I don't understand the meaning of this your call. What do you want from me?
Egondo, your husband was a very great man of this land. He commanded respect from the class of kingmakers. He was equally my friend. And I think I owe him a duty to guide his family.
I quite appreciate your compliments about my late husband. But what I don't understand is guide his family. Are we making any mistake?
Your son, Tinua, is coming after the daughter of my late brother. And from the look in their eyes, they may decide to become man and wife. That will be a huge mistake. Not just a mistake, but a costly one. Yes, and I wouldn't want the great son of a great man to end up with a maiden that is cursed.
Hey, I said it. I have told my son to stay away from that maiden, that she is not good for him, but he wouldn't listen to me. Are you saying that she is equally cursed?
Naturally, I would be happy that the great son of a great man is coming after my late brother's daughter. But I cannot allow your son to stay with her. That curse should end up with another man and not your son. Especially not the son of a great man like your husband. If I allow it, your husband may rise from his grave and strike me dead. So I don't want that to happen. Now, go back and do what you must do.
Chie, thank you. Thank you. I said it. Chie, thank you. I will do as certainly as you said. Hey!
That boy still comes here, despite all I told him and his mother. What do they want from me? To have me murder somebody physically and then tag me a murderer?
Mbam, this is not good now. After all that you two went through to be together. Hey! What are you going to do now?
Well, Chinua says he will keep talking to his mother.
Yeah. By the way, I heard about what you did to Nduka.
Biko. Biko, Biko. Do not talk about that fool right now.
Ada, don't you think it's high time you gave up on this, your fighting habits? Has it not cost you a lot? Ifugonian, Ngwan, now you are the verge of losing the only man you've ever loved.
Please, Nduka deserved the beating he got. Can you imagine him going behind my back to talk to my mother? On Apwala. Why would he do that? Why?
So. He meant well. Ada. And every man will go to any length to get what he wants. You know that. I think you should learn how to tolerate people more. It will go a long way for you. Besides, this is Nduka we are talking about. He's royalty.
Ginewe Mesia, if he's royalty. Do not get me upset. I'm Kwaniyama.
Missy, like I said before, I am not going back. Whatever it will cost me, I'm ready to pay it. That girl has not only taken all that my late brother left behind, but she has brought bad luck to this family. And I want her out of the way once and for all.
I can see. You have been to so many authorities for this same purpose.
Oh, yes.
With that result.
Yes, you are right. I've been everywhere.
it's either the charms are not working on her, or that they tell me that since her father died, that she has now become very strong. You see, it came highly recommended, and I believe you can do this.
She's a very strong woman. The spirits that follow her are very strong. But don't panic. You have arrived at the right place.
I understand that no one comes here and goes back the same. You see, I have no way to pay. I want to pay, but I want her dead.
Oguma galane moro no kanwa. Orole no banyi jama fashemu nabiala no. Asemu nabiala no. If I can tell, that which is mightier than the cricket shall be allowed in the home of the cricket. Have this.
Do exactly as I've told you.
You shall come back to thank me. You come back dancing before my shrine. You don't know why they call me Mbese. Mbese.
Ada, don't you think it's high time you gave up on this your fighting habit? Has it not cost you a lot? Ifugunian, now you are the verge of losing the only man you've ever loved.
She's right. She's right, and I know it. But if I do, people will be keen to take me for granted. I need to constantly remind them that not every woman is a weakling. Oh, but you know, I don't want to lose him. His mother does not like me because of my fighting habit. In order to gain her love and be Chinua's wife, is to turn a new leaf. It's going to be hard. But I'll try.
If my memory has not failed me, the last time you were here was when I buried my husband, Moibo. Why are you here?
You know me, I love to mind my own business.
And if I may ask, is this your business here? I am sensing that you are here to start another round of mischief. And I will not let you...
No, no, calm down. I am not here for mischief. Rather, I am here as a friend of the family.
A friend of the family indeed. How do you mean?
It is not your making that the gods gave you only one son. And that one son has grown to be a great man in Ameke. You cannot stand opposite your own son.
What do you mean, opposite my own son? Moibo, have they sent you? Have they sent you?
You should know me, Moibo. I am a busy woman. And I don't have time to be sent by anyone. Allow this young man to marry the maiden of his choice. If you try to stop him, you will see a different Chinua entirely. You are going to regret it.
What is her business in this? Who
kind of dream is this?
Please now, Ada, please. At least hear me out. Hear me out.
Hear you out.
Yes.
Hear you out to say what? What difference would it make when I hear you out? The news is everywhere. So you can go ahead and be with her.
Listen, Ada, listen to me. There is nothing going on between Nkechi and I. There is nothing.
Yes.
Okay. You know I can never lie to you. Nkechi happens to be the daughter of my mother's best friend. She is the girl my mother wants me to marry. And I told my mother that she, my mother, should marry her.
Why did you not tell me there was somebody in your life? Why? Did I have to find out this way?
Listen to me. It is not what you think. It is not what you think. You know I can never love any other woman the way I love you. I can never. You are the only woman I love. You are the only woman I love. You are the only woman I want. You are the only woman I want to marry. Don't you get it?
I decided to stop fighting. I decided to become more tolerant. Do you know why? Because I love you. Because I want to be with you. I gave up everything just to be your woman.
Listen to me.
My ancestors, gods of Ameke, I thank you for the life you've given to me and my daughter. I put our lives into your care. May every evil eye watching us be blinded. May every evil feet working against us be broken. We shall live out our time. At this junction where three footpaths meet, I ensure our lives in the hands of the tripod authorities upon which Ameke stands. If they come from the left, we shall escape from the right. If they come from the right, we shall escape from the left. Please, take these items from me before dawn. It will be an assurance to me that my prayers have been answered.
Thank you.
dịkwa iche. Chukwu nke igwe, biko kedụ ife m ga-eme? Kedụ ife m ga-eme ka ndị mmadụ ghọta n'ụmụ? Nna m do, biko zọba nwa gị. Chukwu nke igwe, biko tiwa alụm ụzọ. Dịkwa iche, omume mụ dị iche, obi mụ dịkwa iche.
Ada, stop. Are you no longer a strong woman? Don't cry for a man. To be with him. Mama, you could not stop me from fighting. But because of him, I stopped. Now look at me. Look at me.
It's okay. It's okay. Jamba. Don't worry. Another man that will love you will come.
I cannot love another. I don't want to love another. It's just Chinna that I want.
I'm not going. I'm going to go. No, it's okay. It's okay. It's okay.
It's okay. She refuses to talk to me. I go to her house, she gets into the hut, she refuses to come. She sees me on the road, she looks the other way around. Just when I was beginning to live a happy life, she just comes and takes my joy away.
She is hot. Seeing you with another woman broke her heart. That is because she loves you.
Nene, but Mama is the cause of all of this thing. She keeps sending Kechi my way. I have told her I don't want to marry Nkechi. The more I try, the harder they get.
My son, let me tell you one thing. What the gods have written, they have written. If Adeje Jemba is yours, then the gods will bring two of you together.
I'm not happy.
I'm not happy. I'm not happy.
Please.
I'm not happy.
I was coming to see you.
Coming to see me for what? Huh?
The last visit didn't end well. That's why I'm here.
Listen to me. Let me tell you what your last visit did to me. It cost me the love of my one and only woman I cherish so much. That was what your last visit did to me.
Who? Ada? Obi. You know you can't compare me with her. You know. You are too good to be seen talking to her. Talk more of loving her.
Well, will you shut up? Will you shut up? And who are you to judge her? Who are you? Iwonye?
Okay. Obi, why are you doing this to us?
Will you get your hands off me? Come on, get out. Now listen to me. There is no us. There was no us. And there will never be an us. Did you get it?
What is going on here?
What is going on here is your wife. The girl you brought to marry, not me. That is what is going on here.
Nkechi, my daughter. Nkechi, what's the problem? Chinua.
Don't call me.
Chinua.
Nuba.
Chinua.
Chinua.
Nkechi, what's the problem?
Thank you.
understand you. Eh? If truly you have moved on, why are we here? Why are we waiting for Nkechi?
Because I need to remind her of who I am. She cannot come from nowhere and take my man from me. Mba, I want to teach her a small lesson.
Oh, come on, Ada. The truth remains that you left Chinua and not the other way around.
Because he betrayed me. Obia!
Obia, Ada, please, let's not do this now. Eh? Because... Hmm?
What is it, Ade Jejemba? That is for speaking when you have not been spoken to.
What did I do to you?
Some of you seem to have forgotten who I am. Some of you seem to have forgotten what Adeje Jemba can do.
What have I done?
You don't get up when I'm talking. My children again. Now get down on your knees. Down.
Ada.
She cries.
Is she crying?
Look at you. You don't even have strength. Cry, cry. Chinua does not like little girls. He loves his woman strong, bold, and hardworking. Like myself. Like myself, I said. Gail, cry, cry. Chinua should come and see how miserable you look right now.
That's enough.
Nobody. Nobody shares anything with Ade Jejemba. Am I clear?
Yes.
Am I clear?
Yes. I will never go close to him. I will never, never.
Come around like a chicken that you are! Ew.
Ade Jejemba! Ade Jejemba, this is not the way to do it though!
Charm is buried. It is buried. You must resist every temptation to set your eyes on it after burial. If you do, I will not be held responsible for whatever that will happen.
For this.
Wait, because for how long?
For how long shall we continue this? Look, my life is... My life has been so sad without you.
I feel the same way too. But what can I do?
Come back to me. That's what you can do. You do not have to allow something that is so irrelevant come in between what we feel for each other, what we have shared together. It's not worth it.
Chuni, I cannot share my man with another woman.
Listen to me, Ada. I can swear on my life. I can swear with what I share with you. There is no other woman. There is none other. It's only you. Believe me.
I'm confused. Even if what you just said is true, what about your mother? She does not like me. The woman hates me.
No, she does not. She does not hate you. She's only concerned about her only son. Listen, Ada. She will come around. All I need from you is a little time, Ada. A little time.
Get out of here! Get out of here!
What is your problem, Nebolisa?
This is your own father's wife that you are molesting, and it's not fair.
And what is your business in my own family? Who is she to tell me what I do with my father's abandoned house?
And who told you that this house is abandoned? Nebo, listen. Look, this is my husband's house, and I will not allow you to sell it.
Listen, woman. The men that are coming from Ugezu, they are coming with money. You better leave this place and don't spoil the business I've already perfected.
Unbelievable. You call selling your father's house to strangers from Ugezu business? What did you just do? You want to slap me?
Don't make me do. This is not your father's house. Leave me and my business. And you, get out of here. Who get out.
This
get out. Get out.
Leave me.
Are you a fool?
Hey, if you don't leave here, I will kill you.
You will kill Ade Jejemba?
Yes, I will kill you. This is not your father's house. It is my business.
Now leave here.
Get your hands off that woman! Your father think again! Get up and come and fight your woman! You have to fight your woman! Bully of a man! I do not know you before, but this is a warning. Desist from molesting women and helpless people. Because the next time Adeje Jemba will catch you. Mwogi! Machebi bro! Kitama ala chagaya! Ndibu Mwogi! Come out of prison, Ndibu Mwogi. Mama, I hope he did not inflict any wound on you. Ogonwelo.
Thank you, my daughter, thank you.
Hey, that maiden is a hero, in fact. She is an angel. I wonder what that madman would have done to my friend. Hey!
You are eating your words.
Mama, I can't believe you're the one saying all this. I mean, all this about Adeje Jemba, the same Adeje Jemba.
I was misled by what I heard about her.
Hey, but I told you she's a good woman. She only fights people like Nebolisa.
I didn't know. Coupled with what our uncle told me, you can't blame me.
Okay. Okay, Mama. Now that you found out that Adeje Jemba is a decent, hardworking, courageous woman, what is your final impression?
The fact that she saved my friend does not make her the kind of wife I want for my son. She can kill you one day. A fighter will always be a fighter. I still don't understand this. Eh? Since after that strange pot was found, it has been from one sickness to the other for you. You have refused to see any medicine man or herbalist.
Joker, I already told you. I don't need them now. I'll be fine.
You will be fine like this, eh? Look at you, Nai. Just take a look at yourself. You're going down by the minute. Nai, tell me, do you want to die? Do you want to make me a widow, Nai? Let me call the Biegure.
No! No! I don't need any Dibia. I don't need them.
Nice. No, I will not call any Dibia.
I will not call them. No.
Tell. Kwanu!
Yeah!
Kwanu!
Yeah!
Kwanu!
Our in-law, the great hunter of Ameke Kingdom, has fulfilled all the requirements to have you as his wife. But before I bless this marriage, I want you to take this cup of wine and submit to the leadership of your husband, Magiji.
Okay, go there. And I'll go back. Go back.
Marriage ceremony.
Hey! Hey, Lopetife!
Avolamuzu!
Hey! Ebonis!
You just like disgracing everybody. Do you have to call out there?
Objageli.
Mama!
Do not talk to your father like
Mama,
that.
Leave me alone. What is wrong with you? Don't mind her, butterfly. Will you shut up the fire and slap off your eyes? It is obvious that your miserable life with a village loafer has not taught you any lesson. Yeah. By the way, who did you leave your child with?
Who did you leave your child with?
Papa, I left her with Ugona's mother.
Huh? And you are here making noise. Huh? What are you doing here?
Nothing.
Before I open my eyes and close it, let it be that you have disappeared from this compound.
Nai, you don't expect her to leave now. It's already late.
Listen, I may not be able to use my two legs anymore, but that should not give you the impression that I am no longer the man of this house. I am still in charge in this house. Obegri, get inside and go and pack your things and return to your husband's house.
If you are afraid of the dark, don't worry, I will see you off.
Don't see me off.
Come on, let's go.
Nah.
Will you leave your child with?
Nah, you cannot do this now. Eh? This is her father's house now. She's free to come here and sleep anytime she wants.
Why will she go and get pregnant for a man she knows she cannot live with? Huh? She brought it on herself.
Now you're talking like this. But everybody in this village knows that you spoiled Obiageli. 80% of what she's going through now is caused by you.
Me?
Yes, you.
And you, the mother, where were you?
You want to send my daughter out by this time of the night?
Papa will not hear of it. He said I should return to him immediately.
Papa will not hear of it. No. No. Not good at all. The truth is, you made a mistake. But that is not enough reason for you to spend your entire life with such a miserable man.
I have tried hard to make Papa understand. And to think that that fool beat her up, laid his filthy hands on her.
Are you joking?
I wish I was.
Does he beat you? Is it true? Chuan, does Papa know he beat her?
He does. Papa knows.
He knows, yet he wants her to return to him. Why? Listen to me, Begili. If Uncle does not want you in the house, pack your tent and come and stay here. There is no way you will live in the same house with such a good for nothing man. Talk more of being his wife. It's not possible.
Stop crying. I said it. Where is she? Ada! Where is she? Where is she? I said it!
Hey, what is the matter? Has a market be set on fire?
I said it! But nobody will listen to Egondu.
Mama, you said what? You said what? Must you shout at everything?
Oh, I'm shouting. My son says I'm shouting! Oh!
Mama, calm down. He didn't mean it like that. Can you feel me?
The problem is that you have rubbed mud on the face of my family.
Mama, please. What's the meaning of this? I will not have you talk about my wife like that. How the guinea?
Your wife?
Yes!
You call this one your wife?
Yes!
Mbanu, no! She's not a wife because she does not behave like one.
Egondu, I keep warning you about your mouth.
No, leave me. This is not about my mouth. The news is all over the village that my son's wife almost beat her brother-in-law to death yesterday.
Adam, is it true?
Is the answer not written all over her face? If she denies, then she's worse than we think.
Please talk to me.
I can't explain it. I find it difficult to sleep when injustice is reported to me. I believe I need help. It's okay.
All right. Mama, this is the wife of my youth. The gods gave me to wipe away my tears and my shyness. She is a light that shines through my life, and I will not allow anybody, Mama, I mean nobody, to destroy what we share together. Odogene!
Oh, Chinua, don't give me that. Have you lost your senses or what? You married a warmonger, and you must open your eyes and see what she is.
No, Mama, my eyes are wide open. They are wide open. You are the one who has refused to understand what she said.
Mama, she said she needs help. That's what she said. Don't you understand that? She needs help. And this family must give her the help she needs.
You know why, Mama? Because she's the one who is going to bear the children that will continue the lineage of this family. She needs help, and we must give her help.
Ewo! Am I not finished? What did she give to my son? Why can't he listen to me?
She needs help. This family must give her that help. I expected you to ponder on those strong words.
The one that watches us when we sleep and when we are awake. The gods of our forefathers. We bring sacrifice of thanks to you. With this fowl, pure as the sky, let our daughter be free from all the influence upon her life. She's now a married woman, and we know she's expected to have children for her husband and the family. But this will be difficult if the spirit of war still dwells in her. And the spirit of war must leave her this night, so that the spirit of peace and reproduction shall descend on her. Without the gods, it is done. Adeje Jemba is free. She is now free from the spirit of war. And that spirit of war must pursue those that have been pursuing her life. The land. The priestess of the land is here, and she must not be kept waiting. Who is that person that the gods have decided to visit?
Chimo, what does the priestess of this land want with us?
She does not go out at night for nothing.
Hey.
The priestess of the land is here. And she must not be kept waiting. Who is that person that the gods have decided to visit?
I thought you was going to see her.
Eh?
Let's go.
Can you behold her face this night?
I'm not coming. I'm not coming.
We must be brave.
Her message could be crucial. Let's go.
Great priestess of our land, I greet you. Woman, where is your husband?
My husband is a sick man. He does not work.
I must speak to your husband. And he must take the message directly, or the message shall take him. One thing must happen this night.
Priestess, I am a great man of this land that the enemies are killing softly and slowly. What message do you have for me?
The vessel has been cleansed. The gods have cleansed it. And they have sent me to warn you never to lay hands on it again.
What vessel? Talking about?
You are a dying man. You blame the enemies, but you know what the problem is. Papa. Confess your sins and live. The same powers of our ancestors that freed the vessel can visit you. But you must turn a new man. Do it now that they are ready to listen to you. Gather the people and let them know what you did.
A man must be a man. I am a masquerade. And I cannot be humbled by a woman just because she's a priestess.
Nai, what is all that about? I'm lost. Ogini Neme, what is happening?
There is a huge conspiracy against me. But I must prove to them I remain the great Ilopotife. Bulamusu wana tulego.
It may interest you to know that Adeje Jemba is already pregnant. But that's not why I'm here. I visited the priestess to offer sacrifices for my daughter's safe delivery. And she told me that she has warned you before. Ilopotife, confess your sins! Confess your sins or you will...
Shut up, Wayema. I am talking because of my brother. He has gathered the support of the ancestors and they are preventing me from joining them.
Chimo.
They want me to continue in this pain.
So, Nai, why don't you confess and free yourself from this pain?
I hate Adaite Chemba so much.
No. Your hatred means nothing to us. Adeje Jemba is now married and she will soon deliver with or without your hatred. Free yourself from the gods. Ilopotife, free yourself from the ancestors.
My brother, only second. Why are you doing this to me? Why are you forcing me into this ridicule? Why?
Nai, please listen to me. I am your wife. I will not deceive you, Nai, please. Nai, why don't you just confess? Confess, do you like yourself the way you are? Eh? They have rejected you in the land of the dead. Look at you.
Ibu squano, enoiraka, niiraka. Eh? I confess, please. Confess, na biko. Confess and leave. I.
Who was responsible for making Adaije Jemba a fighter so that she will be killed and then my brother will be childless?
Hey!
Chimo.
I was the one responsible for why Emma not conceiving and found another child after Adeje Jemba.
Hey!
I made my brother to die. Yeah. I wanted him to be childless. I wanted to have everything.
My mom.
Now I have lost everything. I have lost everything. Nothing is left again.
Amam wakemoni abinulo. Hey!
I like the look on your face.
The look in my face is nothing compared to the joy that is in my heart. You know what? You're the best thing that ever happened to me.
Ada, look at you.
Very soon you'll be a mother.
Yes. And that is because you did your job as a man. I'm so glad I married you. I believe the gods brought us together for a reason. And they have good plans for us.
Yes, they do. They do.
Mother. I didn't know you were around.
You know, there is something I have always wanted to tell you. And I believe that this is the best time to say it.
Go ahead, Ine.
I came close to you and I discovered that you are the true definition of a woman. You are the best. You are the best thing that has ever happened to my family. Adeje Jembank.
Sweet love,
one,
Isanere mo